हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेकंड ईयर कॉमर्स क्लास. इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द फीचर्स ऑफ बॉम्बे स्टॉक एक्सचेंज. अपार्ट फ्रॉम बॉम्बे स्टॉक एक्सचेंज इन इंडिया वी हैव गॉट अनदर फेमस स्टॉक एक्सचेंज कॉल्ड एज नेशनल स्टॉक एक्सचेंज. I have written just NSE. So NSE stands for National Stock Exchange. National Stock Exchange. So both these BSE and NSE have got their headquarters at Mumbai. So if you would like to know about them, means every night you watch the news, the entire summary, the total result of the transactions of the stock markets of India is released by these BSE and NSE. You might have heard about this one, Nifty. Nifty is the name of the NSE index. National Stock Exchange Index. Maybe in news you might have heard about this. Sensex points. What are Sensex points? It is nothing but sensitive index of stock markets. So what is the index? Indicator of share prices. Okay. Index is called as the indicator of share prices. As you know that securities in any market, not only in India, all over the world, the securities of a joint stock company are highly speculative. Highly speculative means on a particular day a share may be 100 rupees, next day it may become 150 rupees, or it may come down to 90 rupees. So there will be fluctuations in the share prices, ups and downs will be there. Because in a stock market, basically when we are discussing about the prices of securities in capital market, I have told you that the security price is not in the hands of the management of the company. It is decided according to the demand and supply. Okay, in the market, if supply of shares increases, price may fall down. If supply decreases and demand increases, price will increase. You will learn about that demand price supply relation in economics in a better manner. So the same thing is applicable to securities also. So on a particular day, whether the share market is increasing or decreasing, how the points are showing the increasing trend or decreasing trend, that is calculated by the Sensex points. So there is an index for every stock market. The index of NSE is known as Nifty. So every day if you read in the newspapers or you watch news from now onwards, because already you are going through the stock market, now try to understand. Before this lecture, you might not be knowing what is Nifty. So Nifty is the name of the index of NSE. Bombay Stock Exchange Direct Index, BSE index points, they do not have any special name. So BSE stock market, BSE index is separate, NSE index is separate. NSE index name is Nifty. How do they calculate index points? Based on the trading taken place on a particular day. How much investment has come into the stock market, how many shares are been sold, how the share prices have increased and how many number of shares have decreased. Based on this, there is a formula. Every stock exchange will have a base point. Based on that, they will calculate. Like for example, always we compare our marks with 100. Suppose if out of 50, you'll get 40 marks, then we say that 80% marks are there. How we got 80? So when you got 40 out of 50, we have calculated out of 100. So 50 में से 40 mark आए, तो 100 में से 80 आते. So we are always comparing with 100. So we are describing it as percentage, 80% marks, 70% marks. Similarly, every stock market in India, BSE and NSE, have got their own base points. So based on the number of transactions taken place on a particular day, according to the increase or decrease in the share prices, the index is calculated. Such index is called as Sensex. Every night you will get the graph. Very particularly the Telugu students can see in ETV news. Chustarama ETV Vartalu right 9 o'clock, between 9:25 and 9:30, last 2 to 3 minutes, at least 1 minute is allotted for this stock market news. So there you can see, they will say that first of all the graph, Sensex has started at 16,300 points, it went up to 17,000, in the afternoon it came down to 15,000, again raised to 16,200 and it stopped, gained 200 points. So graph pura aap dekh sakte. Okay, at least if you don't understand the language, so 9:25 to 9:30 ke beech mein aap ETV news dekhe to aapko daily Sensex ka news batate points with graphics, with colors. So with this graph you will understand how the share prices are increasing or decreasing, whether the investors have gained or lost. Based on that only, everyday newspapers will be telecasting the share price, or even newspapers when you read, you can see this symbol. This triangle symbol will show increase in share price. Unfortunately, if this is reverse, decrease. Okay, so try to understand that. This also you can gain lot of knowledge when you read the newspapers. That's why I say every day have the awareness, read the newspaper content. So it is all general topics, very useful, because stock market consultancy is also one of the option for commerce students. Like when you always think about the jobs, okay, employment problem. So if you have got enough knowledge in stock market, you can become a stock market consultant. So kya kar sakte aap, jinke paas paise hai, कौन से कंपनी में शेयर्स खरीदना, कैसा बेचना, इन्वेस्टमेंट कैसे करना, रिस्क मैनेजमेंट क्या है, ये सब आप वो लोगों को बता के आप कमीशन कमा सकते हैं. इवन यू कैन बिकम द स्टॉक ब्रोकर इफ यू हैव द नॉलेज अबाउट स्टॉक एक्सचेंजेस. सो दिस इंटरमीडिएट कॉमर्स इज वेरी यूजफुल, इट हैज़ गॉट एवरीथिंग जनरल नॉलेज. सो यू नीड टू हैव द ब्रॉडर कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ दैट, जस्ट नॉट बाय हार्टिंग द आंसर एंड राइटिंग फॉर 4 or 5 marks एंड गेटिंग 5 out of 5 इज नॉट यूर जॉब. Apart from scoring the marks, you should know, once you go through this topic, now you must be in a position that what is the role of stock exchange in India, how the stock market performs, who are the people involved into that, how the share price is fixed, what are Sensex points. This all you should be able to understand now, from now onwards. So that is what called as the real knowledge. Now coming to the concept of NSE, features of NSE. It is a computerized nationwide stock exchange where NSE members all over India linked via satellite and cable system. Though it is completely not online like Bombay Stock Exchange, NSE has got nationwide stock exchange link. It means this NSE enables the stock brokers of other stock exchanges in India to communicate with the help of satellite. I hope you all know satellites and cable system. Okay, so that means people can exchange information about the share prices. For example, in Hyderabad, what is the value of the share in local companies, how many number of shares are quoted in the Hyderabad Stock Exchange, that can be communicated to a broker who is operating in NSE with the help of this satellite or cable system. So these are all the olden versions. Nowadays internet has come. Through mails you are able to communicate, through internet you are able to communicate. So communication system has changed. Here you are given that it is satellite and cable system in the olden days. So in simple, we have to understand that this NSE enables all the stockbrokers of India to communicate among themselves through satellite and cable system. The second important point is the automated quotation system. The automated quotation system makes it convenient to the brokers to buy and sell electronically and need not shout in the trading ring about prices. What is a quotation? A quotation is the price list. Simple. When the price of the share is written on the paper, it is called as a quotation. Not only share, if anything. Quotation means when the shopkeeper or the trader or the manufacturer discloses the price on the paper. A paper consisting of the price details of a product or of anything is called as a quotation. For example, if you come to Sri Medhavi College for admission and the concerned officials, the staff people will write you MEC plus CPT, fees is this much, for materials this much. Like that they will give, show the fee structure. That is a quotation. Suppose you want to buy a bike, you go to a showroom and the customer, the executive over there will make you sit over there and he will write down, sir, bike cost is this much, insurance is this much, okay, nameplate this much, seat covers, so this is the total price. So the details of the price are written on the paper, it is called as quotation. So in NSE, prior to this NSE's trading system, National Stock Exchange has introduced a automated quotation system. Automated means we need not involve again and again. When a particular task is done without the intervention of human being in a repeated manner is called as automated. Like automatic washing machine, how does it perform, Suma? Simply you put clothes, you give some, pour some, means add some washing powder, switch on the connections, so completely it will wash. The only thing is at the end of the time limit you have to take the clothes and just dry them. Even almost 90% they are dried, only you have to put it in the air. I hope you understood my example. Automatic washing machine, automatic cooker, okay. Means you need not do that processing. Simply you put proper quantity of grains and items and water, switch on that. So once the cooker food is cooked, then you will get a whistle for that. It is an automatic cooker. Automation means you don't need to involve. Similarly, before this NSE's automatic quotation system, in stock markets there was a physical shouting system. Physical shouting system means what? Sometimes you might have visited vegetable markets. See how the sounds will be there. Okay, they will be shouting about the prices of vegetables. 100 ke 3 kilo, 100 ke 3 kilo, 10 ke 5, 10 ke 5. Sune kabhi vegetable market mein? Sometimes even during the santas also, in the retail market, nowadays what are going on in the streets of Hyderabad, when the vegetable santas are going on, there also you will find this type of shoutings. Means people will be shouting about the price of the product, whether it is vegetable or something. So previously in stock markets also there was a shouting system. That means the broker who wished to sell a share used to be in the trading ring, a place where from where the stock market operators do participate in the trading. So they should hold the share and shout, I have got Reliance company share, it is 500 rupees, it is 500 rupees. Someone will shout, I have got Tata company share, 600 rupees, 600 rupees, like that. So that this type of shouting was there. So it has been avoided. Okay, how? Automatic quotation system means simply when you have got some computer with you. So if a broker is having computer in front of him, the stock market operator will mention the price and the number of shares he holds. So that price will be displayed on the screen. You need not shout. Suppose you possess some 5000 Reliance company shares of 800 rupees each, the same thing you mention on your computer. 5000 number of shares at the rate of 800 rupees. So it is automatically displayed. You need not shout. Pukarne ki zarurat nahi hai. System mein enter karo, screen pe dikh jata. That is the second feature. Next, it deals with the wholesale debt market like government securities. Wholesale means National Stock Exchange deals with bulk quantity of shares, not like 500,000. It will deal with thousands of shares. Debt market means where you need to borrow money. Debt means taking the loan. Credit means you give the loan. So here, National Stock Exchange will act as a platform to get more amount, particularly for the government securities. Many times I told you while discussing about the financial markets, not only private giant stock companies, but in our country, government also requires lot of funds for the welfare and development activities. They require more money. So government cannot beg the people, like I am constructing a bridge, I am constructing a market, I am constructing a school, please give the money, like that. They cannot beg. So what they have to do? They have to issue securities. Some bonds are to be sold to the people to get money, and that money is utilized for the development of the country. Later on, these investors are paid with a reward. So this National Stock Exchange will collect lot of money from the people by issuing large quantities of debt instruments in the markets. Okay, that means it will act as a platform between the government and the common people, and it engages in wholesale debt market. That means instruments are sold in large numbers, not the smaller numbers. Next, price data means what is the share price of different companies. What is the share price of Reliance company? What is about Tata company? What is Andhra Bank? What is about any private company, LIC, Air India? Different companies are there, thousands of companies are there all over the world. So an investor would like to know what is the price. Accordingly, he will plan his investment. What is the money he has got and how many number of shares he has to purchase. So accordingly, he will plan. So that is the reason they require data. Data means information. Information about what? Prices. So National Stock Exchange will provide this data. That means it will be telecasted, it will be broadcasted by the PTI. What is PTI? Press Trust of India. PTI is the Press Trust of India. What is it? It is an autonomous body under the government. Okay. It is a corporation working under the government, which is authorized to telecast the news, PTI. It is the official broadcaster of all government news. Nowadays, so many media channels are there, but officially sometimes some news can be given through PTI only. So Press Trust of India. So National Stock Exchange has got a collaboration with PTI. So time to time about the share prices, it will be informing the PTI. In turn, PTI will broadcast it to the nation with the help of various television channels. That means common people will come to know about the share prices and what is going on, how the activities are taking place in the stock market. That comes to the people through the PTI. Next, it improves the settlement system. It improves the settlement system. What is the settlement? See, when you take something, you have to give something. Suppose if I have purchased shares from Reliance company, I have to pay cash immediately. and the stock broker has to give me the shares. But unfortunately, in Indian stock markets, there is a problem in settlement system. That means they take lot of time in handing over the shares, and people also take lot of time in transferring the funds. Sometimes even though money is paid on time, we are not given the delivery of the shares. What are the documents we have purchased? They say it come tomorrow. Even nowadays you see banks also. Sometimes you go and pay the money, or they say you have taken the gold loan. Now after certain number of months, you have cleared them. Now you should get back your gold. But once you go and pay the amount, the banker will say that, sir, it is very heavy rush today, please come tomorrow so that your gold will be returned. So we have to pay cash and get the receipt. Again tomorrow we have to visit. Sometimes again there may be some server problem, some internet problem, sir, so that employee is absent, again he will postpone. So what happened here? We have done our job, but we have not received our item. So this settlement is not completed. Similarly, you see many times students, we impart education, but you don't pay the fees. So for collecting the fees, we have to put more efforts than education. This has become a headache for junior colleges and schools nowadays. Earlier, this was not like that. Once a student has joined, means, okay, very fair, some fees is fixed. They would use it to pay the fees, and the college used it to spend among the lecturers and other people. It is a cycle system. Students pay fees to the college, college will pay the amount to the lecturers, and lecturers will teach the subject. Nowadays you are seeing in newspapers, private school teachers are begging on the roads, they are asking for charity, they are working as laborers during this corona time. Due to this COVID-19 pandemic, most of you might have seen in TV news or maybe in newspapers or through your social media that private school teachers are literally begging or have become the laborers. Why? Because the private school managements have not paid the salaries for them, though they are employees. They are removed from the job. If their salaries are asked, what they are saying? Parents have not paid the fees. Once parents pay the fees, we will be able to give the salaries. So like that, one is blaming the other. So this is what called a settlement system. Settlement means when something is done, the reciprocation needs to be done immediately. Okay, suppose if I am working here, so I should be paid salary for my services. So this is called settlement. When it comes to stock market, what is the settlement here? A broker sell off the shares to other broker. That broker may sell it to general public. So this transaction, handing over of shares, receiving of payment, is to be done immediately. But that was not happening earlier. But National Stock Exchange has improved the system by establishing the online system, improving the internet facilities, communication system. It has improved that system. Nowadays, within very short period, the settlement is going on. Investors are happy, brokers are happy, they are getting the commission on time. Clear? Then comes, it operates dealings in the corporate equity and debt instruments. What is corporate equity? Means shares and debentures of various joint stock companies, all multinational companies all over the world can be traded through National Stock Exchange. Then debt instruments, even the other day also I told you, instrument means a paper which helps you to borrow some money is called as a debt instrument. For example, if this is the paper, when I can give this paper to someone else and can take some money, means this will act as a debt instrument, a document which has the capacity to borrow some money from others is called as a debt instrument. On a later date, maybe after 1 year, 2 months, 30 days, that person will come back and gives me this document back, and he will take away his money. That is called as debt instrument. Okay, that will be having a proper stamp, some official information, signatures, so it is valid. That is called debt instrument. So National Stock Exchange will deal in this corporate equity and debt instruments. So in our next class, we'll discuss the other topic. I hope you understood this. Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange, from today onwards, you watch the TV news, Okay, learn about Sensex, read the newspaper, see how the share prices are increasing and decreasing, go through the Nifty points. Okay, try to understand the news about NSE and BSE, how it is gaining, how the share prices are increasing or decreasing, sensitive index points of stock markets you learn, and read the newspapers every day. Clear?
Right.